Lately, I've been experimenting with creating this noisy and imperfect, almost 8mm film look, and I've been doing it in camera by using this guy. Hey, my name is Josh, and this channel is all about making films with little to no money. So if you're a filmmaker who's trying to make micro-budget films like me, definitely subscribe, because I will have more videos like this coming. I also make films, of course, and so I post those here too. This year, I found myself really getting into these films that are more about feeling and characters than they are about a traditionally structured plot. Films like Chungking Express, Fallen Angels, and True Stories. I've just found them really comforting, and I can put them on almost any time and just enjoy it. I think the unique ways that these films express themselves isn't unlike this technique I'm going to show you today. Imperfections can do something special that a really clean, crisp digital image can't quite do. Okay, so you may be wondering, like, what is this thing? It looks like a lens cap, and it is. But it has one thing that's very different, a very, very tiny hole in it, which makes my camera basically a pinhole camera. I don't even totally understand pinhole cameras, but what I do know is that it doesn't let in a lot of light. So the advantage of doing this digitally is that you can bump your ISO up high enough that you can actually get usable shutter speeds and exposure to take video with this thing. There are some things you definitely need to know first. There's some tricky challenges with this. All right, let's get it out of the way. The price, a whopping $12. It does have a micro thin layer of glass on the backside of it to help prevent dust from getting in. And speaking of dust, that is going to be your greatest enemy using this guy. If you have any dust on your sensor, like a speck, it probably is going to show up in the video. I thought I was fine going into this because I never had any dust spots show up when I use my normal lenses, but the thing is, this thing is just not forgiving at all. So I actually had to buy some things first in order to get all the dust off my lens to use this. So I ended up having to get one of these rocket air blasters to blow dust off of the sensor, but even this actually wasn't enough. I had to get a second thing to get some lingering dust off. Sensor swab things, and then that did the trick. So you're probably gonna wanna blow out the sensor like every 5 minutes or so just to be safe. At least if you're shooting, you know, something really important like a film or a music video. You just can't quite tell on your little LCD screen if there are dust spots. Maybe with a bigger monitor you could tell. So these could be additional expenses if you don't already own them. But to be honest, these are like two important investments that I kind of wish I already owned going into this. So as far as focusing goes, it's interesting because everything is in focus and yet nothing is quite in focus because it's kind of soft. So it's hard to say exactly what focal length this pinhole lens equates to, but if you look at my Fuji 23mm, it's pretty close to that. So another thing you can do to emulate the film look is to set your white balance to daylight or 5600 Kelvin. You don't want to set it to auto because film doesn't have a white balance, it just comes in film stocks of tungsten or daylight. Next, let's talk about exposure. And this may be a deal breaker for you depending on what kind of project you want to use this for. So this technique isn't great for inside. You can see here I'm blasting light directly onto my face, and it's enough to see my face, but the whole background is just dark. So you'll probably want to use this outside. I had to bump my ISO up to the maximum a lot of the time. So another thing you can play around with in camera is lowering your shutter speed. For the traditional 24 frames per second film look, that would mean you shoot at 1/48th of a second shutter speed. But you can play around with lowering your shutter speed even more to get more of an 8mm film look. And by lowering your shutter speed, you're raising your exposure. And so that's another thing you can do to help combat the low light issues. And if you want to get even more experimental and crazy with it, you can just keep taking that shutter speed even lower, like to 1/4th or 1/8th of a second, which is what you see here. And it kind of reminds me of the opening scene of Chungking Express. So this is a unique look you can definitely use straight out of camera. If you do want to take things further and try to emulate that 8mm look even more, there's some things you can do in post-production to do that. And I think you would still get a more unique look than if you just shot it with a normal lens on a normal digital camera. So the noise you get in camera can be a little subtle, especially if you're not gonna upload 4K to YouTube, you might lose some of that detail. So one thing you could do is just download a free 8mm or 16mm film grain off the internet, and then just set that to like soft light or vivid light if you want something less subtle. You could also add a black overlay or change your sequence setting so that it's 4x3. I think this could be really great for just something that you want to stand out in your film, you know, a dream sequence, a flashback, or maybe you shoot a whole film this way, like a period film, or just something that seems like this is the right feeling for it. I definitely want to try it out for a short film sometime soon. I don't know exactly what yet, but yeah, I think it'd be really cool. So I have a link to the lens cap and the sensor cleaners in the description below if you want to check those out. Also, if you didn't know, I directed a zombie horror feature film called Deadlocked, and it's available to watch on Amazon Prime for free. I directed it over 4 years ago now in 2016, and I made it for not a whole lot of money for a feature film. It was about $10,000 in the end. And I learned a lot of lessons making it. And I'll be sharing what I learned in an upcoming video, or more likely videos, because there's just so much to talk about with a feature film. If you want to see more filmmaking videos like this, it would really help if you liked and subscribed to the channel. It helps out small channels like mine on YouTube.
My name's Josh, your name's Tom. And I'll see you soon.